only the notebook for the radiation exertion on OSF in exercise, so you can download it.
The folder is visible.
How can I make the folder visible?
Where are you in exercise?
Yeah.
On which day?
14.
Okay. I will do for you. Now it should be public.
Okay, try.
Yeah, we had it.
Okay.
Body.
Okay, so the first notebook is radiation sky view factor. Okay, open it with Jupyter Lab or Jupyter Notebook. In these notebooks, I included a short introduction about the component, about the input and the output of each component. Are you ready? Shall I wait a second? Okay. Are you ready now? Yeah? Okay. So let's start. So the first notebooks, the first notebook is about the Skyview factor. So the radiation component, let's say, is divided in different simulation. The first is the Skyview factor. Then there is the shortwave radiation, the clearness index simulation. Then the longwave radiation, the net radiation, and at the end, the raster case for the longwave and shortwave radiation. Here I have I wrote only long wave because I run the only the long wave radiation, but at the end I add also the short wave radiation. Okay. So the input of the Skyview factor is the dam of your basin. You can open the simulation.
Is always melee you can change.
Okay, the input are the DTM, so the dam of your basin, and the output is the raster of the Skyview factor. Okay. So we can start importing the libraries, the packages. Then set in your notebook the path to the Meledros folder. Update the name of the DTM. Okay, use the one you are using for the other simulation, and try to run it. For the Docker user, you can use this command. For from the console, fuse the console. The yellow sticky note on your PC when you're done.
Study with the school folder with new data.
I
download it again.
No, I use another basin, but update the path and the name.
Yeah, we have the wrong names in the simulation, I guess.
Yeah, update it.
Not in the. No. Your case are applied to Malaysia.
Yes.
Okay, because I downloaded your IPIN files into the dot files into the dot directory of my data engagement.
I use two different basins. The one is the Meledio for the point K simulation. The other one is another basin, a smaller basin for the raster case, because Meledio is too big for the raster computation.
Okay.
So replace this path and this name with your ETL. Change is the name and the path of the input file, and if you want also of the output file. You can find the SIM file or the input of the SIM file. Inside your folder, so set the path to your Meledio folder.
Yeah, I'm working on Skype.
Okay. 20%. Still running?
Yep. 60% almost.
Last week, in the first days, I were using the console because
okay,
Docker
okay.
wasn't working, but since
but
the Docker works.
Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Okay.
Nico?
Sì.
Sì, sì, no, no.
The output is a non-aster. I have a problem with the output because it gets a not a number aster, all of it.
All the output.
Yeah.
The Skyview map, importing raster IO, set the raster path. In this case, as before, change the path with yours, okay? Path and the name. The same here and here. Okay? This is the Skyview factor. It's essentially map where each pixel as a value between 1 and 0 that represent the fraction of visible skies. Okay. Start with the other notebook, the one about shortwave. Okay, so open the notebook. Notebook will find the link to the documentation of the component, and pay attention because the shortwave is the most time consuming simulation we have, so it can take really long time to run. Component description. I saw that Ricardo showed you more or less the same thing, so I think we can go on. Okay. This is the shortwave simulation. Okay. We have different input. The first one is the temperature, the air temperature. In this case is the air temperature in the centroid or in the station point. Depends on you. We can use also the relative humidity if we have this kind of data. If we don't have relative humidity, can simply comment it. Okay. The only data required is air temperature. Then we need the dam, the sky view. And the shape file of centroid or station. Okay. Then we have to set the ID identifier of the shape file. In this case, it is ID. The starting date is. For the beginning of simulation. Then you have a free parameter, as Ricardo showed you before. Okay, these parameters are the zone layer thickness, visibility, and albedo. Okay, more or less they are standard, but if you want, you can change it. And then the output, the path and the name of the output. We have 4 different outputs. The shortwave direct, the diffuse component, the shortwave at the top of the atmosphere, and the total component. The total component is the sum of the direct component and the diffuse. Okay. Okay. Uh, try to run it, but please choose a short period, not more than a year, because it will take very long time.
Repeat the part of the station radiation.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
This one?
Yes.
Okay. So this is the ship file reader component. So you have to set the path and the name of the shape file your centroid.
Okay.
And set the ID of the shape file. For example.
E giusto l'ID controllate means is the ID correct?
Yes. sorry.
Please check it.
Yeah.
And the parameter da letteratura means literature parameter.
Yeah, sorry, I forgot to translate the some comment. If you are using this file, check if the data range is correct. These files run all from 2010 till 2014 or so.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just
going to Grazie.
system in your station.